from Surah Yunus to this Surah Al-Anbiya. These are 12 surahs and subdivided into 4 subgroups of 3 surahs. Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, Surah Yusuf, one subgroup. Surah Ra'd, Surah Ibrahim, Surah Hijr, second subgroup. Surah Al-Nahl, Surah Bani Israel, Surah Al-Kahf, third group. Surah Maryam, Surah Taha, Surah Al-Anbiya, fourth group. Now we come to the next surah, Surah Al-Kahf. Now please note, these two surahs, Surah Bani Israel and Surah Kahf, are a very beautiful example of a very beautiful pair of surahs. Number one, they are absolutely equal in size. 12 sections of Surah Bani Israel, 12 sections of Surah Al-Kahf. Ayat in Bani Israel 111, in Kahf 110, only difference of one ayah. Then Bani Israel started with Subhanallah. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan minal masjid al-haram ilal masjid al-aqsa. This is starting Alhamdulillahilladhi anzala ala abdihi al-kitaba walam yaj'al lahu iwaja. This tasbih and tahmid, they are joined together. According to a hadith, the Prophet said, At-tasbihu nisful mizan wa alhamdulillahi tamla'uhu. You know the scale of the Day of Judgment. Half will be full by tasbih and takbir will fill it. So tasbih and takbir. Surah Bani Israel starting with tasbih. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan minal masjid al-haram ilal masjid al-aqsa. And Surah Kahf, alhamdulillah. Next thing you know, must note, that the last ayah of Surah Bani Israel is Qul alhamdulillah. And here the next surah is beginning alhamdulillah, as if the command which was there in the last ayah, here it's being actively and actually it is being obeyed here. Alhamdulillah. So I told you that in the centers of both these surahs, there is the story of Iblis and Adam. The ayat in the beginning of the sixth section of this surah, ayat in the beginning of the sixth section of Bani Israel. So these are the similarities. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah al-Lazhi anzala ala abdihi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. All praise belongs to Allah who has sent down on his bondsman abd. Here could be rasulihi. But Allah prefers the word abd. This is higher level for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than Rasul. We think Risalat is higher than Abdiyat. No, no, no. In Abdiyat, you face your Lord. In Risalah, you are facing the people to whom you are talking. So actually, Abd is a higher status than Risalah. Abdiyat. In the same way we found in Surah Bani Israel, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Rasulihi. Alhamdulillah alladhi anzala ala abdihi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. Also in Surah Al-Furqan, Tabarakalladhi nazzal al-furqana ala abdihi liyakuna lil-alamin nazira. So all praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has sent down on his bondsman, on his servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-kitab, this book. Wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. And he has placed no distortion in this book. It's a very plain book, very clear book. Kitabun Mubin. Qayyaman. Straight, absolutely straight. لِيُنزِرَ بَعْسًا شَدِيدًا مِنْ لَدُنْهُ. So that he warned of a very big war which will come from your Lord. Now, Basa and Bas here has been translated as a big punishment also. But in Quran we find, when this word is used in as a plural, basa, there can be any type of turmoil, hunger, famine, etc., etc., drought, all these are basa. But when it is singular, bas, heen al-bas, bas means war. So actually, the prophecies of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding al-malhamatul uzma, a very big war which is going to be fought. And we find this also in the Christian tradition, you might have heard, Armageddon. Armageddon is coming. Now the Christians say, it's coming. It's very near. And if you consult a dictionary about this word, you will find a very big war which will be fought between the forces of evil and good before the end of this world. This is the dictionary meaning of Armageddon. So, in the Revelations, the last book of New Testament is Revelation of St. John. And in the prophecies of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is mention of a very big war. So that he warns people of a very big war. وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ and يُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ and he should give the glad tidings to the believers. الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ who not only believe, also do good deeds. أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ حَسَنًا for them will be a very beautiful, very goodly reward. مَا كِسِينَ فِيهِ أَبَدًا and they will abide in it forever, forever. وَيُنْذِرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا and he should warn those people who have said that Allah has taken a son. Now this is the mention of Christians. You know, who at this time are controlling this globe? Who are they? Christians. Jews are controlling the Christians. But Christians are controlling the whole world. But actually Christians, you know, they are the big powers. This America, Europe, everything, everywhere. Then, you know, in the East also. In the Philippines, who? Christians. And now Timur divided. And, you know, half of it is now in a Roman Catholic state, country. In Africa, Christians. They are not allowing the Muslims in Nigeria to establish the Sharia law. Many thousand Muslims were massacred. Why? Because they wanted to establish the law of Sharia in Nigeria, a Muslim majority country. But they don't let him do it. So this is what is happening now. And what is going to be, there is a prophecy of the Prophet. Armies from 80 countries, Christian countries, will come and invade Middle East. And each under each, you know, flag, there will be 12,000 people. So, if you multiply by 12, the 80, 80,000, 12,000 and 80, what it comes to? About 1 million people will be there. Nearly 1/3 of the 1 million were there in the Gulf War also. Now whole this NATO, it is being harnessed afresh, anew, strengthened and expanded. What for? For whom? There is no threat. They say there is a threat from the Muslim fundamentalists. Anyhow. وَيُنْذِرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا and he should warn those who have said that Allah has taken for himself a son. مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ they don't have any knowledge of it. وَلَا لِعَبَائِهِمْ nor their elder fathers, forefathers had any knowledge. كَبُرَتْ كَلِمَةً تَخْرُجُ مِنْ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ very grievous is the word that is coming out of their mouths. Very insulting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِن يَقُولُونَ إِلَّا كَذِبًا they are not seeing except what is it is lying, a big lie. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ so, Muhammad, maybe that you kill yourself in grief over the consequences that are going to take place. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ the consequences of this, you know, dogma of Trinity, this accepting Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam as son of God. So, begotten son of God, begotten. So actually, they say, he is the begotten, the only begotten son of God. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ now the doom that is going to come to them. Maybe that due to the grief, you may perish. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِن لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسْفَثْرًا if they don't come to believe in this Quran. إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا مَعَلَى الْأَرْضِ زِينَةً لَهَا we have made whatever is on this earth an adornment for it. These skyscrapers of Manhattan, these high-rise buildings, these big bridges, these highways, these gardens, these, you know, parks, what are they? They are like ornaments. Just as a woman, she uses ornaments. These are the ornaments for this world, for this earth. Inna jalna ma'ada lardya zinatun laha. It's an adornment for them. لِيَبْلُوَهُمْ لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. So that we should try and test them. Who among them are the doers of the good deeds? What does it mean? This world is very beautiful. Allah is the most beautiful. Now you love either this world or Allah. This is the test. If you love this world, you have failed. If you love Allah, live here. Use it. But don't love it. Live in this world. Use it. But don't love it. Your love should be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the crux of the matter. لَيَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا وَإِنَّا لَجَعَلُونَ مَا عَلَيْهَا صَعِيدًا جُرُزًا. And we are definitely going to make all that is on it, on the earth, a barren soil. When this hour will come, as-sa'ah, everything will perish. These skyscrapers, nothing. The whole earth will become a plain thing without any mountains. Mountains will also disappear. There will be la iwaja wala amta. No height, no depth. It will all be a single plain earth. And on that, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then will come down. And all the malaika will come down. وَجَا رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا وَجِيَ يَوْمَ اِذِمْ بِجَهَنَّمُ. And then, you know, the hell will be brought before their eyes. So all these things are going to happen. أَبْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّا أَصْحَابُ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. Now this surah has two stories. One of the people of Kahf, the people of cave. That is in the beginning. Other is the story of Zulqarnain. That is near the end. Now, actually, these were the questions asked by the Quraysh of Makkah from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the instigation of the Jews. Well, Jews sent them the message that we have come to know that a person amongst you, Muhammad, named Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is claiming to be a messenger of Allah, to be a prophet. Well, you ask him three questions. If you can answer them, then maybe he is a messenger. Who were the people of the cave? What was the story of the people of the cave? Who was Zulqarnain? What is the story? And what is spirit? What is ruh? And the answer to the third question is given in Surah Bani Israel. يَسَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوتِيتُ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. They are asking you about ruh. Tell them, ruh is from the command of my Lord. And you have not been given from the knowledge, but a very little. So you can't understand. The reality of ruh you can't understand. It's the command of Allah. But these two questions are answered here. First of all, this is Ashabul Kahf. And from this is the name of this surah, Suratul Kahf. أَبْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّا أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. Do you think that the people of the cave and the inscription were among our very, very big signs? You may think that there is a very big sign. For us it is nothing. Some people remained alive but sleeping for 300 years. What happens? For Allah it is nothing. But you think it's a very big sign. Now, what is the story? In the second century of Christian era, Roman Empire was pagan, worshipping idols, their mythology, gods and goddesses. And when Christianity was spreading in the Roman Empire, those who accepted the message of Jesus, they were persecuted badly. So in the days of Decius, which we call in Urdu Daqiyadus. Decius was the emperor of Rome in the second century. In his time, some youth, they accepted Christianity. And Christianity was the deen at that time. Hazrat Masih was the messenger of Allah. And Muhammad had not as yet come, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it was the true deen of Allah. So they became, so to say, Muslims and Muwahids. But now, they were brought to the king. And the king said, I give you 7 days. Either you come back to the religion of your forefathers, or then you will be stoned to death. Now these people, when they went back, they thought, what can we do? So they consulted each other, let us go to some cave and stay there and see what Allah does. Left the city, lay there, and this happened in a city, Ephesus, and this was in the present-day Turkey. That was Roman Empire, and it was in this country, this city, Ephesus. When they went in that cave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them sleep. And they kept sleeping for 300 years. Now what happened during these 300 years? Constantine, the emperor of Rome, he accepted Christianity in the year 300 AD, in the beginning of the 4th century. Now the whole empire, Christian, the Roman Empire is Christian. Now when they got up in the 5th century, it was the day of the emperor Theodosius. Now they got up and they thought, how much have we lived here? For how long had we stayed in this cave? Some said, maybe one day or a part of a day. The other said, oh, leave it. We are hungry. Give this silver piece, coin, to someone. He should go and find some good food, clean, halal, so that we can take the food. When one that person came in the city, and he presented his coin. Well, there was, you know, people said, where did you get this coin? It is 300 old years of coin. How did you get it? Maybe you have some treasure. You have found a treasure. So there was, in this way, people came to know that this was the story. They are the people. Because about them, you know, when they had disappeared, their account was written on a tablet and put in the treasure by the emperor. So that is why they are called Ashabul Kahf and of Raqeen. Ashabul Kahf were Raqeen, the inscription. So that was taken out from the treasure and they found they are the people and they have been sleeping here in this cave for 300 long years. But then they went there back into the cave and then they died. And then the people now, because they were Christians now, so they decided that they will make a place of worship on that cave. So this is the story. And this story is found in Gibbon's book, Decline and Fall of the Roman Empire, Story of Seven Sleepers. This Gibbon has written. Now I read the text of the Quran. Am hasibta anna ashab al-kahf wa al-raqeem kanu min ayatina ajaba? Do you think that this matter which happened with the people of cave and inscription, it is one of our very great signs? Is awal fityatu ilal kahf? When those youth came to the cave, Talu, and they said, Rabbana, hatina min ladunka rahma, O our Lord, give us from your own stores mercy, wahayya lana min amduna rashada, and provide us for us rectitude in our affair, salvation. Fadarabna ala azanihim fil kahfi sanina adada, so we sealed up on their years, for some years, that is, they went to sleep. Summa bas now, then we raised them up. Lena'lama, so that we know, ayyul hizbani ahsa lima labesu amada, which of the two parties has kept correct, you know, understanding of how long they had been there. Now in these three ayat, the whole crux of the matter has been given, but the detail is now coming. Nahnu naqussu alayka nabahum bilhaq. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are going to narrate on you their story with truth. Innahum fityatun, they were a few youths. Amanu bi rabbihim, who believed in their Lord, in Tawheed. Wazidnahum khuda, and we increased them in guidance. We gave them more guidance, more yaqeen, more taqwa. وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ, and we strengthened their hearts when they stood. It means stood in the court of the emperor. فَقَالُوا رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And they said and proclaimed over there, our Lord is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. لَن نَدْعُوَ مِن دُونِهِ إِلَٰهًا. We are not going to pray to any other God except Him. لَقَدْ قُلْنَا إِذًا شَطَطًا. If we say that, it will be very exceedingly wrong thing. هَاُولَٰئِ قَوْمُنَا اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ آلِهَةً. These people, this nation, they have taken with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala other gods also. Alongside the big God, written by capital G, God. With capital G, God is omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. But with small letter G, gods and goddesses, thousands of them. So they have adopted gods besides God. هَاُولَٰئِ قَوْمُنَا اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ آلِهَةً. لَوْ لَا يَأْتُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسُلْطَانٍ بَيِّنٍ. Why don't they produce a clear proof thereof? فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنِ افْتَرَىٰ عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. Who is more wrongdoing than the person who is forging lies against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَإِذِ اعْتَزَلْتُمُوهُمْ. And now then they were given, you know, only 7 days. Make a decision. Either you leave this deen of Tawheed, come back to the mythology, Roman mythology, or you will be stoned to death. Now they consulted each other. وَإِذِعْتَذَلْتُمُوهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Now that you have left them and whom they are worshipping except Allah, فَاوُوا إِلَى الْكَهْفِ. Now let us go to some cave. يَنْشُرُ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ. Your Lord will spread for you the bedding of His mercy. وَيُهَيَّ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا. And He will produce for you in your matters ease. وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ. Now what was the position of the cave? Its mouth was towards the, opening was towards the north. So when the sun rose from the east, no direct sun was going into the cave. Indirect light, just as we have the north light, you know, shells are made for big factories and mills, etc. So the sun should not go directly, the rays of the sun, but light should go indirectly. وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ تَزَاوَرُ عَنْ كَهْفِهِمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ. And you might have seen the sun when it rose, inclined from their cave towards the right. وَإِذَا غَرَبَتْ تَقْرِضُهُمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. And when it set, passed by them on the left. وَهُمْ فِي فَجْوَةٍ مِّنْهُ. And they were there in a broad place in the cave. The mouth or opening of the cave was small. Inside, the cave was wide. مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِي. ذَلِكَ مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ. This is from among the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ. Whomsoever Allah guides, He is the only rightly guided person. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ. And whom He sends astray, فَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُ وَلِيًّا مُرْشِدًا. You will not find for Him anybody who is protector and who can direct Him to the right path. وَتَحْسَبُهُمْ أَيْقَاظًا. Had you seen them in that position, you would have thought that they are awake. وَهُمْ رُقُودٌ. But they were actually asleep. وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. And we kept on turning them to the right, to the left, so that they shouldn't have the bed sores, you know, if they are lying on their back continuously. So there will be sores. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is turning them from left to right, right to left. نُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. وَقَلْبُهُمْ بَاسِطٌ ذِرَاعَيْهِ بِالْوَسِيدِ. And along with them was their dog. Maybe a bulldog, you know, very frightening dog. And it was sitting at the threshold of that cave, extending its arms. لَوِ اطَّلَعْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ لَوَلَّيْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِرَارًا وَلَمُلِئْتَ مِنْهُمْ رُعْبًا. If you would have passed by chance and glanced, you know, you would have left there, run away from there in fright. And you must have been, you know, frightened to see this scene. This big dog sitting in the door, you know. Although the door was also asleep, the dog was also asleep or dead, whatsoever. وَكَذَلِكَ بَعَثْنَاهُمْ. And now we raise them up, awoke them. لَيَتَسَعَلُوا بَيْنَهُمْ. So they asked between themselves. قَالَ قَائِلُ مِنْهُمْ. One of them said, Kam labistum. How long have you been here? قَالُوا لَبِسْنَا يَوْمًا وَبَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. They said, maybe one day. How much a man sleeps? One day or a part of a day? يَوْمًا وَبَعْضَ يَوْمٍ. قَالُوا رَبُّكُمْ عَلَمُ بِمَا لَبِسْتُمْ. Then they said, leave it. Your Lord knows best how much period you have been here. فَبْعَثُوا أَحَدَكُمْ. Now send one of you, بِوَرِقِكُمْ هَذِهِ, with this piece of silver, إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ, to the city. فَلْيَنْزُرْ, then he should go and see, أَيُّهَا أَزْكَى طَعَامًا, which is the food which is pure and which is clean. فَلْيَعْتِكُمْ بِرِزْقٍ مِّنْهُ, and they should bring, he should bring some food, some provision from it. وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ, and he should behave courteously. وَلَا يُشْعِرَنَّ بِكُمْ أَحَدًا, he shouldn't fall out with anybody, you know. Then they will say who he is and where are his companions. So, you know, then we are here hiding. لَا يُشْعِرَنَّ بِكُمْ أَحَدًا. Now those who have opened this Qur'an Majeed with them, they should note this word, فَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ. This is the exact center of Qur'an regarding the numbers of the alphabets. Not words, alphabets. Even the alphabets have been counted. In يَتَلَطَّفْ, ta is belongs to the first half, and lam belongs to the second half. And here, according to the number of the letters of Qur'an, this is exact half. إِنَّهُ مِنْ يَيَذْرُوا عَلَيْكُمْ, if they prevail upon you, يَرْجُمُوكُمْ, they will stone you to death. أَوْ يُعِيدُوكُمْ فِي مِلَّتِهِمْ, or they will force you to go back to their deen, their religion. وَلَنْ تُفْلِهُ إِذَا النَّبَدَى, and in that way you will never be able to prosper and succeed. وَكَذَلِكَ عَصَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ, in this way we disclose their matter to them, to the people of the city. لَيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ, so that they come to know that the promise of Allah is true. وَإِنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا, and as for the fixed hour of doomsday, there is no doubt in it. Now if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can keep some people living for 300 long years, can't he resurrect you from the dead? So if this became an argument, because at that time there was an argument going on between people, how people will be resurrected? How is it possible? How can we understand it? So now this sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came before them, and they came to know these are the people, these who had left, you know, who had fled, who had run away, and we couldn't find them anywhere, and their account was written on some tablet. And that was placed in the treasure. And that, you know, tablet was taken out. Oh yes, they are the people. And they have been there for 300 years. Second century of Christian era, they entered the cave. Fifth century of Christian era, they came out. إِذْ يَتَنَازَعُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَمْرَهُمْ. It seems that after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them to death. They died then. And now these people, they closed the opening so that it became a collective grave for them, that cave. Now they were fighting with each other. إِذْ يَتَنَازَعُونَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَمْرَهُمْ فَقَالُوا ابْنُوا عَلَيْهِمْ بُنْيَانَا. And they said, we should erect some, you know, very big building for them, so that people should know who were they. Very, very big saints of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah kept them alive for 300 years. فَقَالَ الَّذِينَ غَلَبُوا عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِمْ. So the people who prevailed in this affair, they decided, لَنَتَّخِذَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ مَسْجِدًا, we shall construct a mosque here to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A memorial, you know, a memorial to them, devoted to them. سَيَقُولُونَ سَلَاسَةٌ رَابِهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ. They will say that they were three, and fourth was their dog. وَيَقُولُونَ خَمْسَةٌ سَادِسُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ. And some people say they were five, and sixth was their dog. رَجْمَمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. This is conjecturing about the unseen, guessing the unknown. They don't know. They don't have the knowledge. وَيَقُولُونَ سَبْعَةٌ وَسَامِنُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ. And some say that they were seven, and the eighth was their dog. This style, you know, in between the lines says that actually this is the correct figure. Seven, sabatun wasaminuhum kalbuhum, and eighth of among them was the dog. Qul rabbi alamu bi'iddatihim, but this is not an issue we should be argued about. Say them, my Lord best knows about their number. Ma ya'lamuhum illa qaleel, people don't know them except a few. Fala tumare fihim illa miran zahira, so don't argue with them, only outward contentions, and that's all. Wala tastafti fihim minhum ahada, and don't ask anybody also about this. But this was necessary to be told to you. This was the reality, and this is sufficient for you. Don't try to go into details. Wala taqulanna li shay'in inni fa'ilun zalika ghadan. And never say, this is very important, never say, I shall definitely do this thing tomorrow. Never say this. Illa yasha Allah. Always add, if Allah wills. I intend to do it, but I will be able to do it only if Allah permits, if there is the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He wills, only. Illa yasha Allah. Now these, you know, these words, they represent our culture of monotheism, tawheed. Whenever something good comes to you, alhamdulillah. You are thirsty, you had water to drink, and what you do say? Alhamdulillah. All praise be to Allah. You see something which is nice, which is beautiful. The flower, very beautiful flower. What do you say? Subhanallah. You know, seeing everything, but remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see something which pleases you, you will find in the next, you know, section. MashaAllah. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed. And it's the same way. I shall do this. I intend to do it. InshaAllah. I will go. Although the car is ready, I got it serviced, you know, and the tank is full, gas is there. Well, I can go. No, no, no. I will not be able to go unless Allah permits. And there is a tradition behind this ayah. Actually, when these questions were said to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, these three questions, he thought that Jibreel comes daily. So this night when he comes, I will ask and tell them. So he said, okay, tomorrow I will give you the answer. Now Allah disapproved of it. He should not have said this. He should have said, inshallah. So because this was a mistake. Now Jibreel is not coming. One day gone, 2 days gone, 3 days gone. Now people are laughing. Finished. Failed. What happened to you? Where is your angel? Where is the Wahi? Then when Wahi came, this instruction was also, وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْنِ إِنِّي فَاعِلُ ذَلِكَ غَدًا. Illa inshallah. Never say for anything that I will do this tomorrow, except if Allah wishes, if Allah permits. Waskur rabbaka idha nasita, and if you forget, and then when you remind yourself and you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then say waqul asa an yahdiyani rabbi li aqrab min hadha rashada. It's possible that my Lord leads me, guides me to something which is better than this. I intend to do this, but maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends something better for me. Why should I decide that I have to do this? I leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If He decrees, if He permits, well, okay, it will happen. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided for me something which is better than this. Asa yahdiyani rabbi li aqraba min hadha rashada. Wa labisu fi kahfihim salasa mi'atin sanina wazdadu tis'a. And they remained in their cave for 300 years, and some people have added 9 years to them. The explanation of some of the Mufassirin is that they were 300 years according to the solar calendar. But as for the lunar calendar, in each century three years increase. So according to the lunar calendar, it was 309 years. So both figures are correct. وَلَبِسُوا فِي كَافِمْ سَلَاسَ مِيَةٍ سِنِينَ. And they remained in their cave for 300 years, was دَادُوا تِسَّا. And added to it were 9. وَلِلَّهُ عَلَمُ بِمَا لَبِسُوا. Again, this is not very important. Say, my Lord knows best how much they remained, for what period they remained over there. لَهُ غَيْبُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To him belongs all the unseen of the heavens and the earth. اب صرف ہی واسم ہے. How excellent seer he is, and how excellent hearer he is. مَا لَهُمْ مِن دُونِهِ مِن وَلِيٍّ. There is no friend for them, no protector for them except him. وَلَا يُشْرِكُ فِي حُكْمِهِ أَحْدًا. And he doesn't make partner anybody in his authority. لَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ. We have read in the last ayah of Surah Bani Israel. وَلِلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ. There has been no partner with him in kingdom as a king. He is all powerful. And here again the same thing. وَلَا يُشْرِكُ فِي حُكْمِهِ أَحَدًا. He doesn't include anybody in his authority. وَطْلُ مَا عُوِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّكَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you recite what has been revealed to you from the book of your Lord. لَا مُبَدَّ لِلْكَلِمَاتِهِ. Nobody can change its words. وَلَنْ تَجِدَ مِنْ دُونَهِ مُلْتَحَدًا. And you will not find any refuge except with him. I told you that the great, you know, that was going on, the pressures on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in those circumstances, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to pay more attention to the wealthy people, to the important chiefs. That if they accept me, then the Muslims will be strengthened. Our position will be strong in Makkah. So he used to pay more attention to the wealthy and to the more important elite of Makkah. But there were poor people also. Bilal and, you know, Khabab ibn al-Arat. There were slaves. This hurt them. That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is paying more attention towards them. They are rich. They are chiefs. But not to us. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is instructing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that you must pay more attention to your poorer companions. وَطْلُ مَا عُوِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّكَ. Recite. And this is the source of strength for you and your companions. Whatever has been revealed to you from the book of your Lord, nobody can change its words. And you will not find any refuge except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ. And content yourself along with those who call upon their Lord mornings and evenings. These fuqara'i sahaba, the companions, the poor people who are calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's praying in the morning also, in the evenings also. وَلَا يُرِيدُونَ وَجْرَهُ. They intend only the face of Allah, that is, His pleasure. They want that Allah be pleased with us. وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. And let not your eyes pass beyond them, seeking the pomp and glitter of this world. These, you know, Rausa, and these chieftains, and these rich people, they have all the glitter, and they, you know, seem very important. But you should not pay more attention to them. وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا. And don't follow or don't give importance to those whose hearts we have deprived from our remembering. وَاتَّبَعْ هَوَاهُ. And they are following their wishes and lusts. وَكَانَ عَمْرُهُ فُرُطَى. And their all affairs are very much extreme. وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. And you should say to them plainly, this is the truth from your Lord which I am presenting before you. فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Whosoever wills, should believe. Whosoever wills, he should disbelieve. It's your choice. I have only to convey to you. قُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. I'm not going to request you. No. No matter of request. I have put before you the truth from your Lord. Now it's your choice. فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. Whosoever decides, he can become a mu'min. He becomes a believer. Whosoever wants to disbelieve and deny, okay, he is free. But inna atadna lil kafir zalimina nara. But for these evil doers, we have prepared a fire. You have the authority. Choice is yours. Go this way or that way. But the result in the hereafter is going to be very different. In the hereafter, we have prepared the fire for them who disbelieve Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who reject Quran. Inna atadna li zalimina naran ahata bihi suradiquha. This nar whose smoke and flames will surround them like the walls and roof of a tent. Vai yastaghisu yughasu bima'in kalmuhl. And if they will aunt and ask for water, they will be given, you know, the molten copper which will burn and roast their mouths. Yashwil wujuh besa sharab. Very bad thing to drink. Wasat murtafaqa. And very bad place to rest over there. That is this Jahannam. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات إنا لا نضيع أجر من أحسن عملا أولئك لهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتهم الأنهار يحلون فيها من أساور من ذهب ويلبسون ثيابا خضرا من سندس وإستبرق متكئين فيها على الأرائك نعم الثواب وحسنت مرتفقا صدق الله العظيم. It's a general rule in Quran that whenever there is a mention of the people of the hell, then for a simultaneous contrast, the people of Jannah, the people of paradise are also mentioned. So in the fourth section of Surah Al-Kahf, we have already read about the people who will be in the hell. Inna atana li zalimina naran ahata bihim suradiquha. You know, they will be surrounded by fire and the smoke of hell. Wain yastaghisu yughasu bima'in kalmuhl. And if they will ask for some water, they will be given some molten brass, molten copper to drink, which will be very hot. Yashwil wujuh. It will roast their mouths and faces. Besa sharab wasat murtafaqa. It will be a very bad thing to drink and a very bad place to rest. Now in contrast, in the lazina amanu wa amilu salihat, verily, those who came to believe and who did good deeds, inna la nuziyu ajra man ahsana amala, we are not going to waste the reward of those who have been doing good deeds. Ulaika lahum jannatu adnin, for them will be the residential gardens of perpetuity, of eternity. Tajri min tahtihim al-anhar, underneath them, rivers will be flowing. يُحَلَّوْنَ فِيهَا مِنْ أَسَاوِرَ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ. They will be adorned therein with bracelets of gold. وَيَلْبَسُونَ سَيَابًا خُضْرًا. And they will be wearing dress which will be green colored. مِنْ سُنْدُسٍ وَإِسْتَبْرَقٍ. Robes of silk and brocade. مُتَّكِئِينَ فِيهَا عَلَى الْأَرَائِكَ. And they will be sitting over there on raised couches. نَعْمَ الصَّوَابِ. It will be a very good reward that will be given to them. وَحَسُنَتْ مُرْتَفَقَى. And it will be a very goodly place to rest. Now in the next session, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving an example of two persons who were friends. One was wealthy, the other was poor. But the wealthy one became haughty. And the poor one was, he was loyal to his Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is a conversation between them. وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَسَلًا رَجُلَيْن. Relate, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to them the story of two people, an example of two persons. جَعَلْنَا لِأَحَدِهِمَا جَنَّتَيْنِ مِنْ عَدَابٍ. We had given to one of them two gardens of grapes. وَحَفَفْنَاهُمَا بِنَخْلٍ. And we are surrounding those gardens of grapes with the palm trees, date palm trees. وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمَا زَرْعًا. In between the two gardens, there was an agricultural farm also. So all the things that he needed were there. There were fruits, there were grapes, there were dates, and there was the farm in which, you know, corn or etc., or wheat, whatsoever he needed, he could cultivate. كِلْتَ الْجَنَّتَيْنِ آتَتُكُ لَهَا وَلَمْ تَسْلِمْ مِنْهُ شَيْعَ. Both the gardens produced its fruit and never, you know, decreased it in any way. وَفَجَّرْنَا خِلَالَهُمَا نَهَرًا. And we had caused to gush forth between them a river. A river was also flowing between the two. وَكَانَ لَهُ ثَمَرٌ. And he had fruit. Now it has two meanings. Either the gardens were laden with fruit, or, you know, fruit of a man is his progeny, daughters, sons. So maybe, as we shall see later on, he had many sons. وَدَخَلَ جَنَّتَهُ وَكَانَ لَهُ ثَمَرٌ فَقَالَ لِصَاحِبِهِ. Now he said to his friend, his man, companion, وَهُوَ يُحَاوِرُهُ. And they were having a conversation among them. أَنَا أَكْثَرُ مِلْكَ مَالًا وَعَزُّ نَفَرًا. I have more wealth than you have, and I have more strength, and the number of people I have with me is much greater than you have. وَدَخَلَ جَنَّتَهُ. And then he entered his garden. وَهُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ. And he was doing wrong to himself. قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ أَن تَبِيدَ هَذِهِ أَبَدًا. He said, I don't think that this garden can perish ever. وَمَا أَظُنُّ سَعَةَ قَائِمَةً. In the same way, I don't think that the hour and the sa'ah and qiyamah is going to come. وَلَئِنْ رُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي. And supposedly, if I am returned to my Lord, لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهَا مُنْقَلَبًا. I'll definitely find much better things over there when I go back to my Lord. قَالَ لَهُ صَاحِبُهُ. Now this is a sort of mentality of rich people. They think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this thing in this world. It means we deserve it. So we shall get in the afterwards also, in the hereafter also. So here he was thinking, primarily either there is no hereafter, no resurrection. But if there is any resurrection, and if there is the life of hereafter, then I shall get more than what I am getting here. قَالَ لَهُ صَاحِبُهُ. Now his companion said to him, وَهُوَ يُحَاوِرُهُ. And he was conversing with him. أَكَفَرْتَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَكَ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. Are you denying your Lord who has created you out of the dust? ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ. And then from a sperm drop. ثُمَّ سَوَّاكَ رَجُلًا. And then he made you a complete man. لَكِنَّهُ اللَّهُ رَبِّي. But as for me, I accept Allah as my Lord. وَلَا أُشْرِكُ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. And I'm not ready to associate anybody else with him. وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قُلْتَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. And why it was not the case that when you entered your garden and you were pleased to see the garden laden with fruit, you should have said, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. This is actually because Allah decreed it to be so. This is because Allah wanted it to be so. It's by the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever I have. La quwwata illa billah. There is no power except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In tarane, if you are seeing me, ana aqalla minka malam wa balada, that I am less than you in my wealth as well as my sons. Fa asa rabbi an yutiyani khayra min jannatik. It's just possible that my Lord gives me a garden better than yours. وَيُرْسَلَ عَلَيْهَا حُسْبَانًا. And he may send over your garden a thunderbolt from heaven. مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتُصْبِحَ صَعِيدًا زَلَقًا. And then all this garden and all this agricultural farm, it will become a slippery plateau. أَوْ يُصْبِحَ مَاؤُهَا غَوْرًا. And it is also possible that this water of this river may go down into the earth. فَلَن تَسْتَطِيعَ لَهُ طَلَبًا. And then it becomes impossible for you to get the water out of the earth. وَأُحِيطَ بِثَمَرِهِ. Now what this person said, it actually happened. He was someone from awliya Allah. Allah loved him. And whatever he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually did the same for with that person, and his gardens were destroyed. Varhita bisamarihi. All the fruit was taken away from him. فَأَصْبَحَ يُقَلِّبُ كَفَّهِ عَلَى مَا أَنْفَقَ فِيهَا. And now he remained there, rubbing his hands against each other on the wealth that he had invested. The garden has been finished. There came, you know, a thunderstorm, a thunderbolt, and everything was gone. He had invested a lot. يُقَلَّبُ كَفَّهِ عَلَى مَا أَنْفَقَ فِيهَا وَهِيَ خَابِيَةٌ عَلَى عُرُوشِهَا. And the garden was lying down on its supports. There are supports for the grape, you know. So now these supports are down. وَيَقُولُ. And then he said, يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُشْرِكْ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. Would that I had not associated anyone with my Lord. Now the question is, whom he had associated with the Lord? There is no mention here of any Lat, Manat, Uzza, Hubal, no God. He believes in one God. Only what he says is that I don't think there is going to be any resurrection. I don't think. And if there is resurrection, this God has given me this thing over here, he will give these things, better things to me in the hereafter also. And he was so confident of his garden. I don't think it can perish, it can be destroyed. What is it? This is the faith in material resources. Here matter and material resources have become God for him. He has all the faith and trust in the material resources. And this is the biggest shirk of today. What is the shirk? Very few people today in this world might be worshipping idols. Even Hindus, very few. Only the lower strata of the society going to temples and worshipping, you know, idols. The higher elite of Indian society also doesn't go to temples, doesn't worship these idols. The shirk is, number one, human sovereignty. This is the biggest shirk. Sovereignty belongs to whom? If you claim sovereignty, you are making yourself equal to Allah. This is number one shirk. Then all the confidence, all trust in matter and material resources. While Iman says that you should have all trust in God, not in the matter, not in the material resources. So this was the shirk that he was committing, not the shirk of worshipping other gods and goddesses. وَلَمْ تَكُنْ لَهُ فِيَةٌ يَنْصُرُونَهُ. But then there had been no hosts who could have helped him مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا كَانَ مُنْتَصِرًا. And it was not possible for him to take revenge. From whom could he take the revenge? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has destroyed his gardens. هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ. Here all authority belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walaya, this is walaya. And another word is vilaya. Vilaya is from wali. When there is mutual brotherhood, mutual friendship, it is vilaya. But authority is from, walaya is from wali. Wali is the person who rules some place or some country, wali. And from wali is walaya. So authority. Authority here belongs to Allah and Allah alone. هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ. هُوَ خَيْرٌ سَوَابًا. He is the best in rewarding. وَخَيْرٌ عُقْبًا. And he is the best regarding the final results. وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Strike to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a similitude for the life of this world. كَمَاءٍ أَنزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. It's like the water that we send down from the heaven. Rain comes down. فَاخْتَلَتَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ. And with this water, rain, water of rain, you know, intermingles the vegetation of the earth, of the land, and comes out. Otherwise, the land was without any greenery, no vegetation, barren. Now water came down, rain poured, and now there is vegetation. So vegetation intermingled with that water and came out. After some time, this vegetation, this becomes dry and broken in pieces. And now the air is taking it from this side to that side, etc. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقْتَدِرًا. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is powerful over everything. Now this is, you know, we, our body, as I said in the Friday sermon today, those of you who were present, our animal existence, our body comes from clay. Our ruh comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just as the rain comes down and the vegetation of the earth comes out due to that rain. Ruh comes from there and the body which is coming from the clay, they join together and that is the life of this world. When we die, the body will go back. مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُهُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَىٰ. But the ruh and the nafs, the life, they will go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الْمَالُ وَالْبَنُونَ زِينَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Wealth and sons, they are the adornment of this life of this world. Now this word zina is coming for the third time here in this surah. First of all, in the first section we had, إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا مَا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ زِينَةً لَهَا لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Whatever is over this earth, we have made it an adornment for this world. It looks very beautiful. And we want to test whether you love this world or you love us. This is the test. Number two, we found, O Muhammad, your eyes should not go toward those people who have zinat of dunya, adornment of dunya. وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. These people who are rich, who are the chieftains, they have the adornment of this worldly life. But you shouldn't go towards them. You shouldn't pay more attention to them. You devote more attention to your poor, your Ahle Iman, your brothers in faith. Although they are poor, but they go on praying Allah, calling in the morning and evening, calling upon Him. And now third time here, Al-Malu wal-Banuna zinatul hayati dunya. This wealth that you have in this world and your sons, they are adornment of this life of this world. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتِ. But the things which will remain are the righteous deeds. Sons will remain here. They are not going to go with you in the grave. Your wealth will remain here. It's not going to go with you in the grave. What will you take into graves with you? Will be the good deeds. They will be permanently with you if you have done some. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتِ. These things which remains and which is eternal, they are the good deeds. خَيْرٌ إِنَّ رَبِّكَ سَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ عَمَلًا. And these good deeds are better near your Lord, when you stand before your Lord. And they are better that you can have hope something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for these deeds. وَيَوْمَ نُسَيِّرُ الْجِبَالِ. And when we shall make the mountains move, they will move and they will become dust. There will be no mountains. It will all be a plain earth. وَيَوْمَ نُسَيِّرُ الْجِبَالَ وَتَرَى الْأَرْضَ بَارِزَةً. And you will see this land, this earth, absolutely leveled and plain, without any adornment. Now the skyscrapers gone, buildings gone, palaces gone. Even Himalayas gone, all things gone, it's all plain land. وَحَشَرْنَاهُمْ. And then we shall gather them, all of them, all human beings. وَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. And will not leave even one of them, all the human beings. From Adam alayhi salatu wasalam to the last human being who will be there in his progeny till the end of this world, till Qiyamah. They will all be present over there. They will all be resurrected and they will have to stand there. And then as I quoted earlier also, the ayat from Suratul Fajr. وَجَا رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا وَجِيَ يَوْمَ إِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will himself descend. And angels in rows and columns and ranks. And then you know, there will be the accountability of the day of judgment. And their judgments will be passed. وَعُرِضُوا عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ صَفَّةً. They will be presented before their Lord in ranks and lines. لَقَدْ جَيْتُمُونَا كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ. Very beautiful. Allah would say, now you have come to us in the same form in which we had created you for the first time. What was that creation of the first time? And what is the creation of second time? First of all of us were created as spirits. No bodies. All the spirits of all the human beings, from Adam till the last man. And we were present there. And we made the covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ. Am I not your Lord? Why not? Oh Allah, we accept you as our Lord. This was the covenant. This is the covenant of Alast, we call it. So this is, we were all present there. But there was no relationship, no father, no son, no grandfather, no grandson. All in only the spiritual forms, not the bodies. Then what happened? Then when, you know, this world of matter was created, and now when a human being's fetus is completed in the womb of the mother, the ruh, the spirit, is brought from there and joined with it. And according to a hadith, it is done after 4 months. It is the hadith from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anh, that for 40 days, you know, it's the nutfa stage. Then for 40 days, it is muzga stage, alaqa stage. 3 into 40, 120 days, that is 4 months. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends an angel and he blows the ruh into it. Now it becomes human being, just as about Adam, وَإِذَا خَلَقْتُهُ وَسَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. In the same way, the son of Adam in the womb of his mother, when it is, this fetus is 4 months old, that ruh is brought and it is blown into him. So now, just as we were standing, all of us, together, before Lord, when we made the covenant, أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ, in the same way, on the day of judgment, we shall be standing all of us together. Father with the son, and grandfather and grandson, all. Adam, from Adam to the last man, which will come in this world, they will all be present. لَقَدْ جَيْتُمُونَا كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ. As we had created you for the first time. Creation for the second time is in the womb of the mother. Bodily creation was in the womb of the mother. First creation was only of the spirits of human beings. وَوَضِعَ الْكِتَابِ. And now the record of the deeds of the people will be brought and placed. Maybe it is a very giant computer. You know, you only touch one button and the whole film of a human being's life is there, you can see. Whatever he uttered is there. Whatever he did is there. For every being, every human being. وَوَضِعَ الْكِتَابَ فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِي. You will see that these culprits, evildoers, will be very much fearful of what is there in this record. وَيَقُولُونَ. And they will say, يَا وَيْلَتَنَا. Ah, woe to us. مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابَ. What type of a record it is. لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا. It has not omitted even the smallest details. All the sins, they have been commuted here. They have been computed here. Everything is here. وَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَادِرًا. And they will find whatever they had done present before their eyes. وَلَا يَسْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. Your Lord is not going to do injustice to anybody. Everybody will be repaid what he did. Not that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to punish one without any deeds, bad deeds that he had committed. وَلَا يَزْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. Your Lord is not going to punish anybody and do any injustice to anybody. Now the seventh section starts, as I told you, with the same story of Adam and Iblis. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ. And when we said to the angels, prostrate before Adam, they all prostrated except Iblis. But this is the only place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has clarified that Iblis was not an angel. Kana min al jinn. He was one of the jinns. Now, malaika were created out of light. In the same way, human spirits, arwah, They are also created out of light. Jinn, jinnat, they were created out of fire. And lastly, human beings, along with all the animals of this on this world, they were created from the this dust or mud or whatever you may call it, from the clay. So these are three levels of creation. Highest level, from light, the angels and human spirits. Second intermediary level, from fire, they are the jinnat. And the lowest level, our animal being. But our existence is twofold. This animal being is at the lowest level, but of the highest level is the spirit that is blown into us. So we have a double existence. While jinnat, they are midway, but they are better than our animal existence. But we are better than them due to the spirits that have been blown into us, and that those are from the light. So jinn can disobey Allah. Humans can disobey Allah. But now the question is, why this was included among the angels? They say that he was a very pious, very learned jinn. And he had been joined with the angels. Because, you know, Noor and Naar are very close to each other. Malaika created out of Noor. And Jinnat created out of Naar. And Noor and Naar, they are very close to each other. In between is one harfi illat, as they call them, which interchanges from this to that, from alif to waw and ye. These three letters, you know, they are huruful illah. Anyhow, there's not time for these discussions. Kana min al jinn, he was from amongst the jinns. Fafasaka an amri rabbihi, so he disobeyed the command of his Lord. Afatattakhizunahu wa zurriyatahu awliya min duni wa hum lakum adu. Now you, O the progeny of Adam, do you want to take him, Iblis, and his progeny, friends to you, leaving me, your Lord, who placed Adam, your grandfather, above the jinnat and above the malaika? But now you are befriending Iblis? He is your enemy. أَفَتَتَّخِذُونَهُ وَزُرِّيَّتَهُ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِن دُونِي. Now you are befriending this Iblis and his progeny, and leaving me. وَهُمْ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ. Although they are your enemies. بِيْسَ لِلظَّالِمِينَ بَدَلًا. Bad is the exchange for these evildoers. Not befriending Allah, but befriending Iblis. مَا أَشْفَتْتُهُمْ خَلْقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. I had not taken them witnesses when we created the heavens and the earth. وَلَا خَلْقَ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Not the creation of themselves. وَمَا كُنْتَ مُتَّخِذَ الْمُضِلِّينَ عَضُدًا. And I am not the one who can take these people who led others to astray as helpers. وَيَوْمَ يَقُولُ نَادُ شُرَكَائِيَ الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ. This subject has come many times before also. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, now call those people or those deities or those gods, false gods, that you used to call upon and pray in the life of your that world. أَلَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ فَدَعَوْهُمْ. They will call them. فَلَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَهُمْ. But they will not answer them. وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَوْبَقَى. And we shall set up a gulf of destruction in between them. وَرَى الْمُجْرِمُونَ النَّارِ. And these culprits, these evildoers, they will see the fire. فَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ وَاقِعُوهَا. And they will be sure now that they are going to be thrown into it. وَلَمْ يَجِدُوا عَنْهَا مَصْرِفًا. And they will not find any escape, any place to save themselves from this fire. وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ. This ayah was there in Surah Bani Israel also. Only the sequence of the words is changed. We have explained in this Quran, for the benefit of humanity, all the similitudes, مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ, and in the various forms, various words, various styles, various sequences. وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ أَكْثَرَ شَيْءٍ جَدَلًا. But man is more than all the creatures in quarreling. He is more quarrelsome than any of the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is not ready to accept. وَمَا مَنَعَ النَّاسَ أَن يُؤْمِنُوا إِذْ جَاءَهُمُ الْهُدَىٰ. And nothing has prevented the people in believing when this guidance has come to them. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّهُمْ. And so that they ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَّا أَن تَعْتِيَهُمْ سُنَّةُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. But the only reason is that the unfortunate end of the ancient nations is going to come to them. أَوْ يَعْتِيَهُمُ الْعَذَابُ قُبُلًا. Or the divine chastisement will come before them face to face. وَمَا نُرْسِلُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْزَرِينَ. And we don't send, and we have not been sending our messengers except as the bearers of the glad tidings and as warners. وَيُجَادِلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالْبَاطِلِ. And those who disbelieve, they rebut the truth by falsehood. بِالْبَاطِلِ لِيُدْحِدُوا بِهِ الْحَقَّ. So that they may rebut the truth with batil. وَاتَّخَذُوا آيَاتِي وَمَا أُنذِرُوا هُزُوًا. And they have taken my revelations, my ayat, with which they are being warned as a mockery, as a laughing stock. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ. Who is more evildoer than the person who is reminded, admonished, with the revelations of his Lord? فَأَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا. He turns his face away from them. وَنَسِيَ مَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَاهُ. And just forget what his both hands have sent forward in stock in the for the life hereafter. إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ أَكِنَّةً. We have put on their hearts wheels. أَنْ يَفْقَهُوهُ. This ayah also has appeared in Surah Bani Israel. We have read it. They can't understand it. وَفِي آذَانِ وَقْرَىٰ. We have put heaviness in their ears. وَإِن تَدْهُوا مِنَ الْهُدَىٰ. And if you call them towards guidance, فَلَنْ يَهْتَدُوا إِذَنْ أَبَدَىٰ. They are never going to be guided to the right path. Now they have rejected the truth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also put a seal on their hearts. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَفُورُ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. Your Lord is a forgiving Lord, a merciful. وَالرَّحْمَةِ غَفُورُ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. لَوْ يُعَاخِذُهُمْ بِمَا كَسَبُوا. Had he seized human beings, mankind, on whatever they did, I commit a sin now and Allah gives the punishment right now. Well, in that case, we have read before also, no living creature would have persisted or we would have remained on the earth. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't punish immediately. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَفُورُ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. لَوْ يُعَاخِذُهُمْ بِمَا كَسَبُوا لَجَّلَ لَهُمَ الْعَذَابُ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have sent the chastisement for them very early. بَلْ لَهُمْ مَوْعِدٌ. No. For them there is a time fixed. لَنْ يَجِدُوا مِنْ دُونَهِ مَوْعِلًا. And they will not find any escape from that fixed time. وَتِلْكَ الْقُرَىٰ أَهْلَكْنَاهُمْ لَمَّا ظَلَمُوا. These are the cities where قَوْمِ عَاد, nation of عَاد, nation of هُود used to live. Those places where Samud, to whom Hazrat Saleh was sent, used to live. Those cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, to which Hazrat Lut was sent. تِلْكَ الْقُرَىٰ أَهْلَكْنَاهُمْ. We destroyed them. وَجَعَلْنَا لِمَهْلِكِهِمْ مَوْعِدًا. And for their destruction, we had fixed a time which was fixed for that. Now, in the next two sections, there is a story, a journey, which Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam took with someone. We are not sure who was he, whose name is not given. Generally, we know him by the name of Khizr alayhi salam. There are various opinions about the person of and personality of Khizr. One is that he was an angel sent down on this earth so that he teaches to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam some of the wisdom, divine wisdom. Some think that he was a saint dead long before, but his spirit is there and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has retained it in this world and it guides people on different occasions, etc., etc. But I think there's no need of going into this discussion. Only the essence of what he taught and what is the reality that Moses came to know through him, that is important. فَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِفَتَاهُ. Just recall when Moses said to his servant. لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبة. I am not going to give up until I reach the place where the two rivers or two seas, they meet. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told him, go there where the two rivers or two seas, they meet. And there you will find a person. And he will teach you certain things. Now, there are two opinions. One is that this is what the Nil, River Nile. Al-Nilul Arzak, Al-Nilul Abyas. There are two Niles, you know, in Sudan. But then they join together. And when it enters Egypt, it is one Nile. So maybe the joining place of the two Niles, you know, the blue Nile and the white Nile, might be that place where he was sent. Wallahu alam. So he said, I am not going to give up till I reach there, where the two seas or rivers meet. Or I can go on for years. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَا مَجْمَعَ بَيْنِهِمَا When they both reached the point of meeting of those two rivers, نَسِيَا هُوتَهُمَا They had for their, you know, breakfast or something like that, some fish, roasted fish. They forgot to take with them. نَسِيَا هُوتَهُمَا فَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ السَّرَبَى Now this roasted fish became alive and dug a burrow in the sand and went into the sea or the river. فَلَمَّا جَعْوَذَا When the, both of them had gone further, قَالَ لِفَتَاهُ Now Musa said to his servant, آتِنَا غَدَانَا Bring us that breakfast, our food. لَقَدْ لَقِينَا مِنْ سَفَرِنَا هَذَا نَصَبًا Now we have tired, we have got it, you know, from this journey, we have been tired now. قَالَ رَأَيْتَ The servant was Joshua, of Bible, Joshua. And we call them Yusha ibn Nun. Joshua, he became the caliph after Hazrat Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam. And under his leadership, the Bani Israel, they captured Jericho. Jericho is the city, which was the first city which was captured in Palestine by Bani Israel under the command of Joshua. And this Joshua is as a servant with Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam in this journey. Qala ra'aita, Joshua said to him, look, is awayna ila sakhrate, when we had taken refuge on that chatan, on that sakhra, on that rock, فَإِنِّي نَسِيتُ الْهُوتِ I just forgot to look after that fish. وَمَانْ سَانِيهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ نَذْكُرَهُ Definitely, Satan made me forget that I didn't mention it to you. وَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ عَجَبًا And that fish, that became alive, and then it took its way into the sea or into the river. And it's a very strange thing that has happened. قَالَ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنَّا نَبْغِي Moses said, Musa alayhi salam said, this is what we were looking for. Allah has told him that something very strange will happen somewhere, and there you will find the person to whom we are sending you. قَالَ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنَّا نَبْغِي He said, this is what we were after. فَرْتَدَّ عَلَىٰ أَسَارِهِمَا قَصَصَىٰ Now they retraced their steps and came back to that place where the two rivers were meeting. And where that fish had disappeared into the water. فَوَجَدَ عَبْدًا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا There they found our bondsman, one of our bondsmen, عَبْدًا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا, one of our servant, from our servants, آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا We had given him mercy from us. وَعِلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا And we had taught him knowledge from the store of knowledge with us. قال له موسى موسى said to him هل أتبعك should I follow you I remain with you keep your company على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا but you will have to teach me some of what you have been taught of right judgment some of the knowledge special knowledge that Allah has given you if you promise to teach me then I should remain with you for some time for some days قَالَ إِنَّكَ لَن تَسْتَطِعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا He said, you won't be able to have patience with me. وَكَيْفَ تَصْبِرُ عَلَىٰ مَا لَمْ تُحِدْ بِهِ خُبْرًا And how can you have patience about those things, about the knowledge of which you don't have? apparently you find I am doing something wrong, and you will not be able to keep quiet. You will speak out, and just as happened, we will see later on. So you will not be able to be patient with me. قَالَ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ صَابِرًا. Moses said, inshallah, you will find me patient person. وَلَا أَعْصِي لَكَ أَمْرًا. I will never disobey you. Whatever your instruction, I will follow. قَالَ فَإِنِ اتَّبَعْتَنِي. Then he said, if you follow me, if you keep my company, فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِي عَنْ شَيْءٍ. Then don't ask anything from me, hatta uhdisa laka minhu zikra, till such time that I myself disclose to you some of the secrets of what I have been doing. Fantalaka, now they departed. Hatta idha rakiba fi safinati. But when they mounted, boarded a boat, kharakaha, he made a hole in the boat, bottom of the boat. Kala kharaktaha li tughriqa ahlaha. How could Hazrat Musa be patient with it? He said, you have made a hole in the bottom of the boat. You want to drown its occupants? لَقَدْ جَيْتَ شَيْءٍ إِمْرَى. Certainly you have done a very grievous thing. قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِعِيَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. He said, didn't I say to you, you will not be able to be patient with me. قَالَ لَا تُعَخِذْنِي بِمَا نَسِيْتِ. He said, but you don't bring me to the book on which I have forgotten. It was just, you know, I forgot. Reproach me not for which I forgot. وَلَا تُرْهِقْنِي مِنْ أَمْرِي عُسْرًا. And oppress me not in my affair. فَانْتَلَقَ. He said, okay. Then they continued their journey. حَتَّى إِذَا لَقِيَا غُلَامًا فَقَتَلَهُ. Till that time that they met a young boy, and he killed him. قَالَا قَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا زَكِيَّةً بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ. Musa said, you have killed a human life, innocent life, without his having killed anybody. No law. لَقَدْ جَيْتَ شَيْءٍ نُكْتَى. Again you have done something very bad. قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكَ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. That person said, didn't I say to you that you won't be able to have patience with me? قَالَ إِنْ سَأَلْتُكَ عَنْ شَيْءٍ بَعْدَهَا فَلَا تُصَاحِبْنِي. Hazrat Musa said, now if I ask anything again, then you can say me to depart. Then don't keep me with you. لَقَدْ بَلَغْتَ مِنْ لَدُنِّي عُذْرًا. You have reached now that level of excuse about me. I won't be able to complain that why you are parting ways from me. Because twice I have committed a mistake, but if a third time I commit a mistake, you will be justified to say go away. فَانْتَلَقَ. Again they continued the journey. حَتَّى إِذَا أَتَيَا أَهْلَ قَرْيَةٍ اسْتَطْعَمَا أَهْلَهَا. Till such time that they came to a township and they wanted the people of that town or village to feed them. Travelers, you know, in the olden times, people used to feed them as guests. For Abawa Yuzayufuma, but those people were so wicked of that township that they refused to feed them and to play host to them. For Wajada Fiha Jedaran Yuridwa in Kabwa. Now they found there in that city or township a wall which was going to collapse. فَأَقَامَ. That person, Uzair, that person Khidr, he straightened it, rectified it. قَالَ لَوْ شَيْتَ لَتَّخَسْتَ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا. Hazrat Musa said, you could demand, you know, labor from them. They are so wicked people, they are not ready to feed us, and you have done this work for them without any wages. You should have demanded wages. قَالَ هَذَا فِرَاقُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنِكَ. He said, now this is the parting of time. This is the time of parting of ways between me and you. سَأُنَبِّئُكَ بِتَعْوِيلِ مَا لَمْ تَسْتَطِعَ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا. Now I am going to disclose to you the secrets about which you couldn't be patient. Number one, أَمَّا السَّفِينَةُ. As for that boat, فَكَانَتْ لِمَسَاكِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ فِي الْبَحْرِ. That belonged to certain poor people who are working on the sea, taking passengers from this side to that side. فَعَرَدْتُ عَنْ عَيْبَهَا. And I damaged it. وَكَانَ وَرَاهُمْ مَلِكٌ يَأْخُذُ كُلَّ سَفِينَةٍ غَصْبًا. Because behind them there was a king who was confiscating and annexing all the boats. Now when he will see that this boat is damaged, he will spare it. So this whole boat will be spared for them. Had it been correct and absolutely fit, then the whole boat would have gone from them. So actually, you think that I have done something bad for them, it is actually good for them, for their benefit, that now that king will not take this boat from them. وَأَمَّا الْغُلَابِ, as for that boy, فَكَانَ أَبَوَاهُ مُؤْمِنَيْنِ, his parents are believers, and they are good people. فَخَشِينَ أَنْ يُرْهِقَهُمَا تُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا, be feared that if this boy becomes mature, he will oppress his parents with insolence and ingratitude. He could see that he is not a gentle man, gentle boy. He will be a headache for the parents. فَعَرَضْنَا أَنْ يُبْدِلَهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا خَيْرًا مِنْهُ زَكَاةً وَأَقْرَبَ رُحْمًا. So we decided that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes him back and give them in its place another son who might be better than him in purity and nearer in affection. وَأَمَّا الْجِدَارِ, and as for the wall, فَكَانَ لِغُلَابَيْنِ يَتِيمَيْنِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ, it belonged to two orphan boys in the city. وَكَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا, beneath the foundation of that wall, there was a treasure for them. وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا, and the father of these two orphans, he was a very pious person. He had saved something for his young orphan sons, you know, when he was dying. And he buried there in the foundation of this wall. Now if this wall, if it collapses, the treasure will be apparent. It will come out and people will take it. Because the orphans are still minor, they won't be able to protect their wealth. So, فَعَرَادَ رَبُّكَ, so your Lord decided it, أَنْ يَبْلُغَ أَشُدَّهُمَا, they reach their maturity, وَيَسْتَخْرِجَ أَكَنْزَهُمَا, and then they take out from that, the foundation of that wall, their treasure. رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ, all this was manifestation of the mercy of your Lord. Apparently you thought I have done something wrong. Now what is the lesson in it? In this world, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends something to me which is not pleasant, I think it is bad. Maybe there is something good in it. أَسَانْ تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَأَسَانْ تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. It's just possible. You might be disliking something, but there is good for you in that. And likewise, it is also possible that you might like something, but there must be bad in it for you. So actually, Allah knows and you don't know. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُ. So whatever is happening in this world to us, we should think, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some good is intended by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بِيَدِهِ الْخَيْرِ, in His hand is all good. Whatever comes from Him is good for me. Although apparently, immediately, instantly, it might appear to be unpleasant for me, but in the long run, if it is coming from my Lord, it must be beneficial for me. This is the lesson of Iman, which Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam got through this journey. ذَلَكَ تَعْوِيلُ مَا لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا. This is the real interpretation of those things on which you could not have patience. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. I told you the questions were, who were the people of the cave? Who was ذُو الْقَرْنَيْنِ? وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ, they are asking you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about ذُو الْقَرْنَيْنِ. ذُو الْقَرْنَيْنِ, first of all, must understood, قَرْن means a horn. قَرْنَيْنِ, two horns. The person having two horns, who was he? Actually, he was Cyrus, Kahf. He was the king of Persia. Before him, Persia was divided into two kingdoms, Paras and Media. But when he rose to power, he joined them together. And he was the actually founder of the great Iranian empire, whose 2,500 years anniversary was, you know, you remember the Jashan, which the king, emperor of Iran, I think about 20 years back, a big ceremony was held. 2,500 years had passed. And he was the founder of the great Iranian kingdom, empire, and he was the founding emperor. He then attacked Babylonia. Babylonia is Iraq. After, you know, west of Iran is Iraq. And Babylonia, there were the Jews who were in captivity. Nebuchadnezzar was the king of Babylonia, who had destroyed the second temple in Jerusalem in the year 587 before Christ. I gave that history last night. Now it is, these things are coming together. So now these people, when Cyrus captured Babylonia, he allowed these Jews to go back to Jerusalem, and they can go and they can have their temple again, build their temple. So these people knew him. And because he had joined two kingdoms to make one, in his, Taj, in his crown, he fixed two horns to represent two kingdoms becoming one. So he is Zulkarnain. Yasaluna ka Zulkarnain kul satlu alaykum minhu zikra. Say to them, okay, I'm going to narrate some of his events to you. Inna makkanna lahu fil ard. We had established him in the land, in the earth. He was a big king. Wa atainahu min kulli shay'in sababa. And we have given means to him for everything. Fatma sababa. So he launched an expedition, conquest towards the west. Hatta idha balagha maghrib ash-shams. So that when he reached the place where the sun was setting, you know, this coast of Mediterranean, when he reached there, now in front of him was the ocean, Mediterranean Sea. And when you stand on the coast, you think that the sun is going down in the sea. When he reached there, وَجَدَهَا تَغْرَبُ فِي عَيْنٍ حَمِيَةٍ. He found that the sun is setting in black, muddy water. وَوَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا قَوْمًا. And there he found a nation. He conquered them. قُلْنَا يَا ذُلْقَرْنَيْن. We said, O ذُلْقَرْنَيْن, إِمَّا أَنْ تُعَذِّبَ. Now you have the authority. You can chastise them if you like. وَإِمَّا أَنْ تَتَّخِذَ فِيهِمْ حُسْنًا. Or if you like, you can do good to them. You can be kind to them. You have conquered them, but you can be kind to them. قَالَ. He said, أَمَّا مَنْ ظَلَمَ فَصَوْفَ نُعَذِّبُهُ. Whosoever does evil, so we should also chastise him. ثُمَّ يُرَدُّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ. And then he will be returned to his Lord. فَيُعَذِّبُهُ عَذَابًا نُكْرًا. And he will chastise him in the worst form of azab. وَأَمَّا مَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. As for those who believe and they do good deeds, فَلَهُ جَزَانِ الْحُسْنَى. His good reward is secure with his Lord. وَسَنَقُولُ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِنَا يُسْرًا. And we also will be lenient to them in our affairs. ثُمَّ أَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا. Now this character is of a very pious person, as if he was a prophet. They say that actually he was a follower of Zartasht, Zoroaster, and he was a Nabi. Maybe. It's just possible. But it is not mentioned in Quran. But he was under training with him. And he, as we find here, as if he is one of the prophets, just like Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. The character is absolutely parallel. Summa adba sababa. Then he prepared for another expedition. Hatta idha balagha matla' ash-shams. Then he reached the place where the sun rises. وَجَدَهَا تَطْلُعُ عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ. He found it is rising on a nation, عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ. لَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِهَا سِتْرًا. For whom we had appointed no shelter. They say that this expedition of Zulkarnain was towards Makran, this Balochistan area. And there the people were so low, uncivilized, that they didn't know how to make roofs. Their houses were only walls, walls separating each other's house, that's all. No roof. So they had no shelter from the sun. Kazalik. This is what happened. وَقَدْ أَحَطْنَا بِمَا لَدَيْهِ خُبْرًا. And indeed, we have all the knowledge that happened over there. What it means? We are not giving you the details. Now comes the third. ثُمَّ أَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا. Then again he prepared an expedition. It was towards the north. حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ بَيْنَ السَّدَّيْنِ. Until when he reached between the two barriers of mountains, he found, وَجَدَ مِنْ دُونِهِمَا. He found on this side of these mountains a nation, common. لَا يَكَادُونَ يَفْقَهُونَ قَوْلًا. They were not able to understand anything. Now this is the place between two seas, the Black Sea in the west and the Caspian Sea on the east. In between them is the Caucasia. This area, mountainous area, also this, you know, Chechnya is also a part of it. Now here are mountains and two, you know, walls of mountains. And there is a way, a broad dara, we will call it. So people from the north, Gog and Magog, used to come through this and attack here and looted them, plundered them, and then used to run back. So these people here, they said to Zulkarnain, Kalu ya Zulkarnain, they said, O Zulkarnain, Inna Yajuj wa Majuj mufsiduna fil ard. Surely Yajuj and Majuj, Gog and Magog, they are from the progeny of Hazrat Yafis alayhi salatu wasalam. I told you three sons of Nuh, Sam, Ham, Yafis, Shem, Ham, Yafis. And this is the progeny. Beyond the central mountainous regions of Asia, north of it, towards east and west both, this is the area where the progeny of Yafis alayhi salatu wasalam settled. So they are also, and the sons, the name of the sons of Yafis are given in Bible, Torah, and they include Gog and Magog. They create mischief in the land. فَهَلْ نَجْعَلُ لَكَ خَرْجًا. So should be a sign for you, some tribute. أَلَا أَن تَجْعَلَ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَهُمْ سَدَّا. On this, that you erect between them and us a barrier, so that they can't cross, you know, this pass between the two mountains. They come through this pass and attack us, and plunder us, and kill us, and then run back. So if you can somehow fill this gap and put a barrier over here and close this pass, then we shall give you annual tribute, so that, you know, this can compensate you for what you do for us. قَالَ مَا مَكَّنِّي فِيهِ رَبِّي خَيْرٌ. He said, whatever my Lord has given me is much better than what you can offer me as a tribute. I don't need any wealth, no tribute. Again the character, the moral character of the person is, I think, just the same as of the prophets of Allah or Awliya Allah, some very pious person. قَالَ مَا مَكَّنِّي فِيهِ رَبِّي خَيْرٌ. What my Lord has given me is much better than what you can offer me in tribute. فَعِينُونِي بِقُوَّةٍ. But help me with manpower, labor. Come on, work with me. أَجْعَلْ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَهُمْ رَدْمًا. I will build between you and them a wall. This wall which he created between the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea, between the cities of Darial and Darbund, you know, there was a gap. And this gap was filled by a wall which he built, 50 miles long, 29 feet high, 10 feet broad at the top. Just like the dam, you know, Mangala Dam and Tarbela Dam. What happens? A mountain this side, mountain this side. And here you erect a wall. This is the dam. This dam is now, it is, the flow of the river is hampered, and now an artificial lake is created, and there is the water, the reservoir. Bangla and Tarbela both. But in the same way, he erected a wall over there. Atuni Zubar al-Hadid, he said, bring to me pieces of iron. Hatta idha sawa baina sadafain. They fill the gap with these pieces of iron, so that when they are leveled up, the gap is finished. Qalan furhu. Then he said, blow in it. Make it a fire. Hatta idha ja'alahu naran. When it was a fire, now bring to me molten brass that I pour over it. So to say, it was the reinforced concrete structure. First, you know, pieces of iron, then they were made red hot, then molten brass was poured, so it became a very, very important, very strong structure. They will not be able, neither they will be able to scale it, come over it, nor they will be able to pierce it. قَالَ هَذَا رَحْمَةٌ مِّن رَبِّي. And he said, this is all the mercy of my Lord. I don't claim any credit for it. I don't boast of anything. قَالَ هَذَا رَحْمَةُ مِنْ رَبِّي. This is the mercy of my Lord. فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ رَبِّي جَعَلَهُ دَكَّنْ دَكَّا وَكَانَ وَعَدُ رَبِّي حَقَّا. When the command of my Lord will come, then this will become a powder. This strong thing that I have made, it will not remain. It will become a powder. And the promise of my Lord is going to be true. It is going to happen. At one time it will not be there, and it is now not there. There are some remains at that place. That is why the name of the Darband. Darband means in Persian, where the door has been closed. Darband. So Darband is the name of that place where this wall existed. But now there is no wall. It has gone. وَتَرَكْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَمُوجُ فِي بَعْضٍ وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ. And when that time will come, we shall leave them surging into each other, fighting. And then the trumpet shall be blown. Now this surah began with the warning of a war. Alhamdulillahi allazi anzala ala abdil kitaba wa lam yajal lahu iwaja qayyaman liyunzira ba'san shadidan min ladunhu wa yubashshir almu'minina allazina ya'maluna salihati anna lahum ajran hasana ma kisina fihi abada. And this is now ending here. Again, there will be a very big war. People and Gog and Magog will intermingle with each other. They will run into each other's columns. Yamuj fi ba'dhin, surging against one another. And the trumpet shall be blown. وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ فَجَمَعْنَاهُمْ جَمَعًا. And then we shall gather all humanity together for the day of judgment. وَعَرَضْنَا جَهَنَّمَ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَرْضًا. And on that day, we shall present Jahannam, hell, for these disbelievers. They can see it now with their own eyes. الَّذِينَ كَانَتْ آيُنُهُمْ فِي غِتَاءٍ عَنْ ذِكْرِي. Those people whose eyes were blind to my remembrance, they never remembered me. They never knew me. They never loved me. They never served me. But now, this is the دِنْبَكَانُوا لَا يَسْتَطِيُونَ سَمْعًا. And they were not listening to my revelation and my ayat. So here, this 11th section comes to an end. أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَن يَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِي أَوْلِيَاءِ إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا جَهَنَّمَ لِلْكَافِرِينَ النُّزُلَا قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا الَّذِينَ ظَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. It's a common principle in the Quran that in the various surahs, the ayat which appear in the beginning and the ayat with which the surah ends, they are most profound, most profound. Same is the case with Suratul Kahf also. And that is why we find traditions and sayings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whosoever will keep reading and reciting the ayat in the beginning of Suratul Kahf and the ayat with which the surah ends, he will be saved from the fitna of Dajjal. So these ayat have a special effect. And because, you know, in the beginning also we found the central ayat was, إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا مَعَلَى الْأَرْضِ زِينَةً لَهَا لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَبَلًا. And I noted it last night that twice again this word zinat appears. وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا الْمَالُ وَالْبَنُونَ زِينَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. So the central idea is that this world is very beautiful. And as man is advancing in technology, the beauty of this world is becoming more and more. It's more and more attractive. More and more awful. So now man is loving this world more and more. And this is the only test to which we have been put in this world, this life of this world. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He has created life and death so as to test you, who amongst you is the doer of the good deeds. And this is the crucial matter, whether you love this world or you love Allah and the hereafter. If we fail in this, if we are fully devoted to this world, then we fail in the akhirah. And if we have fixed our priority number one is that world and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is only a journey. We are passing by it. As the Prophet said, "Kun fi dunya kaannaka gharibun wa aabiru sabeel." You should live in this world as if you are some stranger or a traveler. That's all. This is not your house. This is not your home. Your home is actually akhirah. Now in the end also you find, first of all, the denunciation of the shirk. Mostly the shirk in this world has been that people have adopted as gods and goddesses, according to their own imagination, the daughters or sons of Allah. The some of the Jews said, Uzair is son of Allah, so we must worship him. And you know, Christianity is based on this principle, the only begotten son of God. And he is the God real. That Asmani God, you know, the God in heaven, the Father, Heavenly Father, he is not very important. Really important is Jesus. He is the real God. In the same way, the Mushrikeen of Arab, they had the idea that these angels are daughters of Allah. And that is why they had their deities with the feminine names. Manat, Lat, Uzza, these are feminine names. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَيَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِي أَوْلِيَا. And why do these mushrikeen worship these small gods and goddesses? They think that they will intercede on their behalf on the day of judgment. They will be able to save those people who love them from the accountability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is their wrong idea. Allah says, أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. So then those who have disbelieved, they think, أَن يَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِي أَوْلِيَا, that they can make my servants, my bondsmen, as their protectors against me. Jesus, I created him. I sent him as a messenger. Now will he protect these people against me? Against my questioning? Malaika, they are my creation. They are my bondsmen. Will they intercede on their behalf against me? أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَيَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِي أَوْلِيَا إِنَّا عَتَدْنَا جَهَنَّمَ لِلْكَافِرِينَ نُزُلًا. For such disbelievers and rejectors of the faith, we have already prepared hell for their entertainment and hospitality. Now the crux of the matter of Surah Al-Kahf. قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, should we inform you who are the greatest losers regarding their deeds and endeavors in this world? Everybody is working hard from dawn to sunset, rather late night. People are working, 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 running. Running to this direction, running to that direction. But what is the goal? What is the aim? Now, if all this running and all this endeavor and all this striving is for this world, it means they are lost. They are gum, according to the saying of Iqbal. Kafir ki ye pehchan ke afaq mein gum hai. They have been lost in this world. أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Say to them, shall we inform them, who are the greatest losers in their striving in this world? And after this question, the answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving himself. الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Those whose endeavor is wasted for this world only. All their time, all their working, all their exertions, day and night for this world. As if they are lost. Their striving, their endeavors, they are lost. الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ الصُّنْعَ. And they think that they are going very good performance. Well, my business is flourishing, but I have put in labor in it, hard work, and the result I am having. My business is flourishing, I am shining in my career, in my profession. So they are contented that what they are endeavoring, they are getting the results. But the reality is, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. They are the people who have disbelieved the revelations of their Lord. Allah says that is the real life, not this. This is only a temporary abode. You have to leave it. If not today, tomorrow. If not tomorrow, day after. That's all. Nobody says that he can live in this world forever. He has to leave. So, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. They may be saying that we believe in Quran. But if all their efforts are focused and lost for this world, then actually they don't believe in Quran. Quran says the real life is that, not this one. So you are belying Quran by your action, by your attitude. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ وَلِقَائِهِ. And they have denied that they will have to meet him, meet their Lord. فَحَبِتَ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. For all their good deeds which they might have done, they have all gone in vain. فَلَا نُقِيمُ لَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَزْنًا. And we are not going to assign any weight to them on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment. Such people also do some good deeds to satisfy their conscience. Well, I am all very busy in this world affair, but I am earning, but I am giving some charity also. I am doing that business also. That, you know, public service work also I'm doing. No, these things. Unless your goal is Akhirah, unless you devote yourself for the most of your personality and your time and your energies and your means for Akhirah, for the pleasure of Allah, you are doomed. ذَلِكَ جَزَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ. They are the people whose reward is going to be the hell. بِمَا كَفَرُوا. Due to the rejection of the faith, وَاتَّخَذُوا آيَاتِي وَرُسُولِي هُزُوَا. And they took my revelations and my messengers in mockery. What is he saying? That is the real life. Or oh, real life is this. Babar Mahesh Posh, ke alam dubara neest. This is the life. Enjoy as much as you can. Because there is not going to be another life. Babar Mahesh Posh, try to have as luxuries as you can have. Alam dubara neest. This life will not come to you again. So avail the best of it. That is actually, Babar had said so. We are doing according to that. Our whole life pattern is absolutely on that basis. Now the contrast. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. On the contrary, those people who believe and do good deeds, كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُلُوا. For them, the gardens, they have been prepared, gardens of paradise, shall be ready for their hospitality. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. Abiding therein forever. لَا يَمْهُونَ عَنْهَا هِوَانَا. They will never like to be transferred from there to any other place. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي. Please note, the last two ayat of Surah Bani Israel were started with قُلْ. قُلِدُ اللَّهَ عَبِدُ الرَّحْمَانَ أَيَّمَّا تَدُوْ فَلَهُ الْأَسْبَاعُ الْحُسْنَى. قل الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الظلم كبره تكبيرا. The grandeur of the person of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his high station, his uniqueness, his unity. Two ayat, the last two ayat of Surah Bani Israel, very, very profound. In this same way, the last two ayat of Surah Kahf, they also start with قل. There are two quls in the end of Surah Bani Israel and two quls in the end of Surah Kahf. We are very well aware and familiar with four quls. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. But these are four other quls that you must remember. They are remember worthy. Now the grandeur of Allah's creation. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if the whole sea was to be used as an ink to write the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, the sea will be exhausted before the words of Allah are exhausted. Although another sea of that like might be brought for its help. Now what does it mean? Every creation of Allah is His word, kun. Everything He created by one word, kun. So every creation is a word of Allah. Can you count down and write down all the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Even if the oceans are to be used as ink, and there's another ayah in the Quran of this on the same subject. If all the trees on the earth are to be turned into pens, kalimatullah will not be able to be exhausted and written. So this is to give you an impression of the grandeur of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now comes the last ayah, and this is the practical tawheed. One tawheed is theoretical. Allah is alone. Nobody is equal to Him. None is a partner with Him. There is no associate with Him. There is no associate in His attributes, etc., etc. All these things are theoretical. What's practical tawheed is, you worship Him and Him and Him alone. Obey Him and Him and Him alone. You can obey others only where there is no disobedience to Allah. Your obedience, your worship should be 100% focused on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the practical tawheed. I have a book on this subject, Tawheed-e-Amali in Urdu. And this aspect of tawheed is absolutely absent. Even those of our people, you know, who think that they are the muwahideen and they are the salafiyun, and so on and so forth. They don't care about this amali tawheed. Now here is the amali tawheed. Last ayah of Surah Bani Israel, theoretical tawheed. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدَا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ وَلِيٌّ مِنَ الذُّلِّ وَكَبِّرْهُ تَكْبِيرًا. And here, قُلْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Verily, I am also a mortal human like you. The only difference between you and me is yuha ilayya. Wahi has come to me. Revelations have come to me. And what is the crux of the revelation? Annama ilahukum ilahu wahid. That your Lord is the only one Allah. One Lord, one God. No partner with Him. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. So whosoever is hopeful and looking forward to meet his Lord, فَلْيَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Now he has to do two things. He must do good deeds. Number one, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. And he shouldn't associate in his obedience to Allah. Ibadah means obedience. Abd is slave. In obedience and worship of Allah, he should not associate anything else, anybody else. So this is the end of Surah Al-Kahf.